Hi guys, Codetutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande. In the previous video, we started discussing about the remote mining where we have implemented first half of the logic. That is, we have created a messenger and a handler. Any message that comes to that particular application or service has to pass through a messenger. Messenger will in turn pass the message to the handler and handler will receive it, process the message. In this particular video, we will see the other half of the implementation wherein another application which has an activity needs to implement the logic to connect to the service which is generating the random number to fetch a random number. For that, we will get started with the implementation of another messenger. This particular messenger will be initialized with a iBinder. If you remember, in the service, we have implemented the onBind method which returns a iBinder from the messenger object. So this particular iBinder that we are creating in the activity will be actually having a reference to a handler that we have created in the service. In abstract terms, we are setting two address to the message. This is how application which needs to connect to the service will come to know where it needs to connect. The activity will connect to that particular service and that particular message will be channeled from the iBinder to a messenger. In this way, we will be completing the first half of the circuit which is connecting to the service. Now, we will go through a code which explains this in a technical way. So if you recall, in the previous video, we had created a service. This service was a part of an app called as service side app. So I have created another app here. The name of the app is client side binder app with an activity which contains these three buttons. Bind service button will basically connect to the service. Unbind service will unbind from the service and get random number will basically fetch the random number from the service and display it. Now, let me open the activity where the actual logic resides. You can see that I have three buttons and then a service intent variable which I will be using to bind to the service int random number value which will be holding the random number returned from the service. We basically need to implement the service connection object. This service connection object will be used to bind to service. And as you are aware, when you create service connection, you have to override two methods, service disconnected and service connected. If you go back here in line number 28, I have created two messengers. That is random number request messenger and random number receive messenger. Random number request messenger will be used to send the request to the service and random number receive messenger will be used to handle the received message from the service. So in the on service connected method, you will see that I am initializing these two messengers. The random number request messenger is initialized with the messenger passing the binder as the constructor argument. And we are getting this binder from the on service connected. This is the same binder that is being returned from the onBind method of the service that we have implemented in the previous video. The another method is onService disconnected. I am just initializing both the messengers to the null. And I am also using a variable yumIsBound to decide whether successful binding has happened or not. On service connected, I make yumIsBound equals to true. In the on service disconnected, I make yumIsBound equals to false. And now we have to finally establish the connection. For that, we need to initialize the intent. If you come down in the onCreate method, here we are initializing the intent. We are setting the component. We have a method called as intent.setComponent, which is another way of setting the explicit intent. I have covered explicit and implicit intent in a detailed manner in another video. In explicit intent, we are clearly telling which component that we want to trigger. So if you go back to the another app which contains the service, you will observe that whatever the package name that I have used in that particular app, this particular package name and fully qualified name of the service, I am using that in setting the intent in the client app. So this is the package name of the other app and this is the fully qualified name of the class which implements the service. So we are basically setting the service that we want to trigger using this particular intent. After this, we basically have to implement the logic behind what should happen when I click on the bind service button, unbind service button, and get random number button. So I have written a method, private method, bind to remote service. In the bind to remote service, I am invoking bind service, passing the service intent which we just initialized here, and I am passing the random number service connection which we have initialized here, and I am using the flag bind auto create. You can check my previous video what this means. On successful connection, I just basically want to show a toast message saying that service is bound. And on click of unbind service button, I will invoke another private method, unbind from remote service. So this method will basically invoke unbind service method and it will pass random number service connection that we had passed earlier. And I am just setting m is bound equals to false. Final implementation is fetch random number, which will be triggered whenever I click on the get random number button. However, we will put the hard stop to the discussion now. With this code, we have implemented first part of the implementation where our activity can connect to the service. Now the remaining part is the service responding back with the random number and activity receiving it and displaying it back to the UI. We shall see that in the next video. Stay tuned, share, comment, subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.